So, what are we really made of? Dig deep inside the atom and you'll find tiny particles held together by invisible forces. Everything is made up of tiny packets of energy born in cosmic furnaces.
The atoms that we're made of have negatively charged electrons whirling around a big bulky nucleus.
The quantum theory offers a very different explanation of our world.
The universe is made of 12 particles of matter, 4 forces of nature. The universe is made of 12 particles of matter, 4 forces of nature. That's a wonderful and significant story.
Suppose that little things behaved very differently than anything big. Nothing's really as it seems. It's so wonderfully different than anything big.
The world is a dynamic mess of jingling things. It's hard to believe.
The quantum theory
is so strange and bizarre. Even Einstein couldn't get his head around it.
In the quantum world, the world of particles, nothing is certain.
It's a world of probabilities.
The quantum theory offers a very different explanation of our world.
The universe is made of 12 particles of matter, 4 forces of nature. The universe is made of 12 particles of matter, 4 forces of nature. That's a wonderful and significant story.
All crazy things that things really are like.
Electrons act like waves. No, they don't exactly. They act like particles. No, they don't exactly.
We need a theory of everything.
We need a theory of everything.
Which is still just beyond our grasp.
Still just beyond our grasp.
We need a theory of everything.
We need a theory.
Perhaps
the ultimate triumph.
The ultimate triumph of science.
Offers a very different explanation of our world.
The universe is made of 12 particles of matter, 4 forces of nature. The universe is made of 12 particles of matter, 4 forces of nature. That's a wonderful and significant story.
Wonderful and significant story.
I gotta stop somewhere. I'll leave you something to imagine.
Is a very human form of knowledge. We are always at the brink of the node.
Science is a collaborative enterprise spanning the generations. We remember those who prepared the way, seeing through them also.
If you're scientifically literate, the world looks very different to you, and that understanding empowers you.
There's real poetry in the real world. Science is the poetry of reality.
We can do science, and with it, we can improve our lives.
There's real poetry in the real world. Science is the poetry of reality.
The story of humans is a story of ideas that shine light into dark corners.
Scientists love mysteries. They love not knowing.
I don't feel frightened by not knowing things. I think it's much more interesting.
There's a larger universal reality of which we are all a part.
The further we probe into the universe, the more remarkable are the discoveries we make.
The quest for the truth in and of itself is a story that's filled with insights.
There's real poetry in the real world. Science is the poetry of reality.
We can do science, and with it, we can improve our lives.
There's real poetry in the real world. Science is the poetry of reality.
The story of humans is the story of ideas that shine light into dark corners.
From our lonely point in the cosmos, we have, through the power of thought, been able to peer back to a brief moment after the beginning of the universe.